if Call of Duty Warzone 2.0 shows error code BLZBNTBGS000003F8, then we know how to fix it. Watch this video till the end to learn how to solve the issue. Hey, you're watching Silicophilic, the home of all tech solutions. Error BLZBNTBGS000003F8 on Call of Duty Warzone 2.0 mostly occurs due to connection problem. Follow the steps shown in this video to fix the problem easily. Before we get into the solution, subscribe to our channel for future tech support. Also, like this video if it helps you solve this issue. Don't forget to comment your feedback on the solutions or if you are facing any issues while performing them. We also have a Facebook group of troubleshooting experts where you can share your tech issues and get direct help. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Now, let's jump into the solutions. Method 1. First of all, you can check the BattleNet server status. Visit Down Detector and search for battle.net. Check if there is any server problem on the server side. If you find server outages, then wait for some time and then check again. If you find everything is up and running, then go to the next method. Method 2. The next thing you can do is check if your internet connection is stable. To get a better gaming experience, you should have a good internet connection. Visit speedtest.net and click on the Go button to check your internet speed. Method 3. Another thing you can try is flushing the DNS using command prompt. Click on the Windows Start button and type cmd. Run the command prompt as an administrator. Type ipconfig /flushdns in the elevated command prompt window and press enter. Then, type ipconfig /release and press enter. Next, type ipconfig /renew in the elevated command prompt window and press enter. Now, type netsh int ipv6 reset.log and press enter. Next, type netsh winsock reset and press enter. All these commands are given in the description box. After running the commands, exit the command prompt window. Method 4. The next thing you can do is change the DNS server. Press Windows plus R buttons to open run. Type ncpa.cpl and press enter. Right-click on the network adapter you are using and choose Properties. Click on Internet Protocol version 4 and open its properties. Set the preferred DNS server address to 8.8.8.8 and the alternate DNS server address to 8.8.4.4. Click on OK. Another thing you can try is clearing the battle.net cache. If your BattleNet launcher is open, close it using the Task Manager. For this, right-click on the Windows Start button and select Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab. Check for any processes related to the BattleNet and Warzone. Right-click on the task and select End Task to terminate. Now, open C drive and click on View. Select Show and click on Hidden Items. Next, open Program Data. Delete the Blizzard Entertainment folder and then delete the Battle.net folder. After deleting the files, Battle.net application will not be able to read the location of your installed games. For this, run the Battle.net application and select Warzone 2.0 game. Next, press the Play button. This will start the scan by selecting the directory where the game is installed. Method 6. If the previous method didn't work for you, then you can forward port Blizzard BattleNet. Type Windows Defender Firewall in the Windows search box and choose the top option. Click on Inbound Rules and then on New Rules from the right side. Click on Port. Select TCP. Go to the Specific Local Ports field and enter the local ports. Click on Next. In the Action window, click on Allow the Connection option. Click on Next. Check the three boxes for Domain, Private and Public. Click on Next. Give a name to the role to save it and click on Finish. You will find the new role under the Inbound Rules section. We need to repeat the same thing with UDP. So, click New Role again. Click on Port and then Next. Select UDP. Go to the Specific Local Ports field and enter the local ports. Click on Next. In the Action window, click on Allow the Connection option. Click on Next. Check the three boxes for Domain, Private and Public. Click on Next. Give a name to the role and click on Finish. Now, you will have to repeat the same method for outbound rules. After finishing the process shown, run the game and check if the problem is solved. If you again encounter the same problem, move on to the next method. Method 7. Another thing you can try is disabling firewall or the antivirus program you are using. Type Windows Defender Firewall in the search menu and choose the top option. Click on the Turn Windows Defender Firewall on or off. Click on the radio buttons for both private and public settings for turn off Windows Defender Firewall. Make sure to turn on your firewall and antivirus protection later as your system is vulnerable to threats without them. So that's it. If this video has helped you in figuring out this issue, then give us a like and subscribe to our channel. If the issue is not fixed with the methods we have shown here, comment below to let us know and our team will try their best to help you out. Also, join our Facebook group for direct tech support. The link to the group is in the pinned comment. Thanks for watching, Silicophilic.